长久以来，阿拉伯国家在中国老百姓眼中一直笼罩着一层神秘的面纱。三年前发生的阿拉伯之春，更是使很多中国的投资者对这片土地望而却步。那么，阿拉伯国家近年的经济发展如何？阿拉伯之春都带来了哪些经济影响？最近，财经记者在北京采访了阿拉伯观察首席经济学家弗罗朗斯·伊德。作为麻省理工学院经济学博士，伊德长期从事发展中国家经济研究，还曾担任摩根大通的中东地区研究主管。下面就让我们来听一听他是怎么说的。
What are the main characteristics for the economic development of Arabic countries?
I think what is notable about development in the Arab world today.Is the effect of the growing populations and the need for job creation. This is something that is not dissimilar to what you're observing in China. There is a massive demand for the provision of new infrastructure in the Arab countries, and the pressure on governments to invest is creating a lot of opportunities for businesses, including for Chinese businesses, in the areas of infrastructure, energy,healthcare, etc. And what has accelerated the pace of this investment drive in the Arab countries is, of course, the Arab Spring, which happened 3 years ago and which provided an even stronger impetus for governments to respond to the needs of the population. So it's been a very dramatic change.And it is providing an investment pipeline for the decade to come. Today, the per capita level of investment in the Arab world is the highest in the world. It's higher than in China, higher than in the BRICS combined, and higher than in all of the emerging markets on average.
Those political changes in Arabic countries, how does those affect the economic performance of those countries?
The political change has put pressure on economic performance. So in the short term, the political change in countries like Egypt, Tunisia, and Morocco and Jordan resulted in a slowdown of economic growth. Okay? And the slowdown of economic growth was obviously problematic for the government because it meant that people who were upset became even more upset. And so that was the immediate result of the Arab Spring.Then what happened is these governments have now started to make very, very urgent the sorts of things that address the Arab Spring. So, for example, they are thinking very carefully about attracting foreign direct investment. They're thinking very carefully about public-private partnerships and BOT schemes for infrastructure development. They are drawing on financial support from multilateral organizations and from the region.In order to stabilize the macroeconomics of the countries and keep the currency stable in each of these countries. So I think when we look back in 5 or maybe 10 years, we will find that the Arab Spring was actually a good thing in the sense that it made the governments very serious about reform and it made them very serious about the need for rapid investment.
据统计，截至去年底，全球伊斯兰资本市场较上世纪80年代扩大十多倍，规模高达1.6万亿美元。全球已发行的伊斯兰债券总额达到1300亿美元，连续第四年创新高，规模相当于金融海啸前的3倍。曾经我们看，平时专门研究这个中东和北非的经济专家还真不多。我们看伊德还是比较乐观的，你是怎么看待这件事情的？
我觉得他说的对，就是阿拉伯之春在长期之内对于整个阿拉伯世界实际上是一个正面的或者是积极的因素。那我们看这一块呢，不仅仅是那些已经发生了政权更迭的这些国家，也包括没有发生政权变化的国家。那么阿拉伯之春呢，实际上使这些国家的这个决策者都必须更多的去关注民生，更多的去倾听老百姓的声音，而且要去满足他们的需求。那么这可能就意味着在将来在这些国家，那么普通民众的这种可支配收入要提高，那么他们的消费需求呢可能也会上涨，那么产品市场呢也会得到极大的丰富。那么这对于外国投资者来说呢都是一个好的消息。我想将来我们可能更多的就不仅仅能够看到中国的一些国企去那里这个给人家建设工程，然后我们进行大量的这种劳务的输出，而更多的我们会看到一些私营或者小的企业，那么向这些地区进行投资。